Unless this is the last bag of the Mustang Lego. This won't be a huge amount to do on this. It'd be the wheels, the bonnet, the roof, and the boot, and then all the other bits for the mods. So what I'm going to do is going to build it as standard, and then once I've done that, show you what it looks like, and then show you how to change it to the modified Mustang, and then show you pictures and so on and so forth. That. So see you at the end of the video. Hope you like it. See you in a bit. Oh, that's the Mustang Complete. It's a beautiful model, isn't it? Yeah, Grenada got this one. It's really nice. You can Lego stores or Amazon, wherever you want to get it, really. It's pretty cool details. I forgot to show you the number plates on the front and the back, obviously. But these are different types you can get as well, different ones you can use. So you got P51 AK2. I don't know what that actually is, to be honest. California ones. I don't know what they are. Must be something for what? I don't know what. Then you got PEK2 ones. We've got a white one, a yellow one, PEK 280, again, no clue. KAM5 81H. I guess they're foreign ones. They look like foreign, different country maybe, or maybe America. I'm not even sure. And you got a couple of bad 5296 ones as well. They're easy to fit onto the vehicle and just go on the front or back, whatever you want to do. I'll just put the normal GT 1976, the year it's built, in there. So that's what it looks like from the front. So you've got the printed, actual printed Lego piece in the front there to make the badge. And you got the bonnet, which actually does open to show you the engine. Don't worry about that bit falling off in a moment. We'll get to that in a bit. Got a front scoop. The wing mirrors, they even mentioned the wing mirrors when I did them last. Very adjustable. You got the boot. Opens up quite nicely and shows you off. It isn't even in there properly yet. That's it. That's why it won't closing down properly. Yeah. And the back exhausts and so on and so forth. And the roof actually is removable, so it makes life easier. You can make it convertible. And also you can turn the steering wheel easier. The wheel still doesn't turn. That's not too bad. So that's what the normal model looks like. So now I have to do the mods. So what you do, you take the front scoop off, that's a side, and you take the normal exhausts off. These just pop off quite easily, all in one go, both of them like that. Then to the side, and also you take the big round blue bit on top of the engine off. Well, that's it. And now for the mods. First of all, turn it upside down and lose the roof. And turn this knob to put the steering all the way, back suspension all the way up as far as it goes. Now it's got a big ride height now at the back. For all those ones who like big mods on the cars. And then you get the engine mods. Surprised they didn't put like a elastic band around this or anything like that. And that just pops in there. It's a specific way around, goes on. Yeah, and it goes in a quite nice, quite secure fit. Then you've got the two engine, the exhausts, replacement exhausts. So they come off the side. So all they do is they pop underneath here. I haven't even tried it yet, so don't know how easy it is. Hold on a sec. Yeah, sorry, I was having a bit of a struggle putting these on, but yeah, they do pop on there easily, he says. both of them about there on the car. So now it's got side exhausts. I'll leave the roof off for a sec because I'm going to be turning over again. See? Then you got the front splitter, that's what they call it. That also pops on there somewhere. About there, yeah. Surprised they've done these sort of mods on this model, actually. It's pretty cool. And then you got the last one, or last couple bits. It's the back. It's a spoiler that goes on the back of the boot like that. So, and this. You know, there's one thing I can say about this. It isn't exactly a strong build. Parts do pop off quite easily, especially these here. These are quite easily to catch, and this actually, he says, sorry, this actually is adjustable, so you can actually have it so it's at different angles, which is pretty cool. Whether you would do that or not is another thing, a real Mustang. But, and then the last one in the boot again. God, another plate keeps falling off. Is the this is not very well made, this is it? He says it's made by me. Let's try and put this back on. Why is it not sticking, eh? Not a good start, is it? See, it stays, comes off. I'll have to leave it off for now. If that's went. I'll remind myself to pick it up in a minute. And you've got the NOS bottle, so it fits in the back. See? That just goes in the boot. Like that so far. And that's it. That's the Mustang with mods all done. So it's quite a nice model. Even the modified version is quite nice too. I think I prefer the normal if I was to be honest. But that's me. Especially this bleeding spoiler kit's coming off. It's not very well designed, I don't think. But yeah, I do like the model. Couple little bits about it. I don't like the easy breakable, easy come off. But I definitely highly recommend it if you like cars and Lego and little mods on it. I've even seen some bloke actually put motors in here, so you can actually have motorized steering and motorized actually driving around with infrared, which is pretty cool. If I can find a link to it, I'll put a link in the description for that. So please hit the like button, please hit the share, hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. See you soon with the next build of probably Terminator. See you soon, bye.